Hello everyone, welcome to Indian Judicial Service. Today we are taking here question number 141 to 160. This is the part 9th of top 400 MCQ of Code of Criminal Procedure. Now question number 141. A confessional statement under section 164 of CRPC can be recorded during the course of investigation only and not afterward. During the course of investigation or at any time afterward before the commencement of inquiry or trial. During investigation as well as during inquiry, but before the commencement of trial. During investigation, inquiry or trial. So in this these options, option B is most appropriate here. So answer is option B, during investigation. So the confessional statement recorded by the magistrate under section 164 during the investigation or at any time afterward but before the commencement of inquiry or trial. Now question number 142. The statement of witness recorded under section 164 of CRPC are substantive evidence, corroborative evidence, both substantive and corroborative evidence, neither substantive nor corroborative evidence. So it is corroborative evidence. Now question number 143. If the magistrate administered oath before a recording of confession, so it is administered oath here, but at the time of confession, and the confessional statement is good in law and the admissible in evidence, not, it is not here, because the confessional statement is recorded without oath by the magistrate under section 164, but there is a sign by the accused or witness. So this statement is wrong here. The good in law but admissible in evidence only on corroboration. Option C, bad in law and inadmissible in evidence. Option D, bad in law but admissible in evidence if corroborated from other evidence. So in this question, answer is option C, bad in law and inadmissible if under section 164 of CRPC the magistrate are taking the oath of the accused before the recording of the confession. So such statement or confession under this provision is bad in law and inadmissible in evidence act. Now question number 144. Where an accused is remanded in police custody and for maximum period of 15 days here, and he can further be remanded to police custody by a magistrate, session court, high court in exercise of its inherent power. And last year, neither A nor B nor C. So option D is correct, because under section 167 there is a provision, the police remand maximum here 15 days. So thereafter neither magistrate nor session court or nor high court have power to exercise to send the accused in to police remand. Now question number 145. Section 167 of CRPC, the longest period for which an accused can be remanded in police custody. So it is clear here, it is 15 days. Now question number 146. Question number 146. Where the accused is granted bail under section 167 subsection 2, the proviso A of CRPC. So here the accused granted a bail under section 167 subsection 2, proviso A, and on filing on charge sheet, the investigation revealed that the accused has committing a serious offense. So here the charge sheet of the investigation shows that the accused committing a serious offense. The bail so granted under section 167 subsection 2, proviso A of CRPC. Option A here cannot be cancelled in the absence of special reason. can be cancelled under section 437 subsection 5, can be cancelled under section 439 subsection 2, can be cancelled under section 437 subsection 5 or section 439 subsection 2. So in this question, answer is here option A, cannot be cancelled in absence of special reason. So there is a special reason. Now I express here which provisions are provided in these given sections. So first of all, section 167, you know that the procedure when the investigation cannot be completed within 24 hours. So the police present the accused before the magistrate, and thereafter the provision of the 15 days remand of police custody, and after judicial custody 60 or 90 days remand, which are already I expressed in previous video. If anybody not watching video, previous video, I will provide a link in comment box. Now these sections 437 subsection 5, this provision is provided in the cancellation of bail in necessary to promotion. So it is the cancellation of bail. If necessary. To promotion. Now section 439 subsection 2, it is the order of High Court or Session Court, order of High Court and Session Court to arrest the accused. So section 439 subsection 2 provided the order of High Court or Session Court to arrest the accused. And any person and who is realized under the bail of chapter number 33 here. So these provisions are here. Now question number 147. The entries in the case diary maintained by investigating officer. Here it is very important here, case diary. Under section 172. So 172 is related to the case diary of CRPC, can be used as evidence to explain the contradiction. No, it is not used in evidence, not explain contradiction for adding. So it is important here, adding the court to decide on a point. Option B and C are correct. So here answer is option C. The CD, it is also abbreviation of this word, case diary, CD. Case diary is used for adding the court. It is the instrument which help the court to decide on a point. So it option C is correct here. Now question number 148. Under section 172 of CRPC, the bar against the production and use of case diary is intent to operate in an inquiry or trial for an offense. B, civil proceeding. C, writ proceeding. Option D, all of the above. So here answer is option A, an inquiry and trial for an offense. Now question number 149, where the police submit a final report. Here final report, it is called FR. Under section 173 of CRPC, a magistrate, and the magistrate is bound by the conclusion drawn by the police and cannot order reinvestigation. And not bound by option B here, not bound by a conclusion drawn by the police and may direct a reinvestigation or a issue process. Option C, bound by a conclusion drawn by the police and has to issue process. Option D, both A and C. So here answer is magistrate is not bound. So option B is correct here. Because the final report submitted by the police to the magistrate under section 172 is provided the provision of case diary, and 173 provided the submission of the police report before the to the magistrate. So the magistrate is not bound by the conclusion drawn by the police, and magistrate may direct the for reinvestigation or issue process. So answer here option B. Question number 150. Where a police submit a final report, here police submit final report under section 173 subsection 2 CRPC for dropping off the proceeding to a magistrate. The magistrate may accept the same, may reject the same and take cognizance, may reject the same and order further investigation. Option D, any of the above. So here answer is any of the above. Magistrate have power to accept the report, to reject the report and take a cognizance, and to may reject the report and for further investigation or any of the. So answer D is correct here. Now question number 151. In submitting a final report under section 173 of CRPC, the investigating agency is obliged to seek an opinion of a public prosecutor, can be compelled by the court to seek an opinion of a public prosecutor, compelled by court. Now option C here, has to carry out a combined operation with the public prosecutor. Option D, neither A nor B nor or C. So here answer is option D, neither A nor B nor C. Now question number 152. The reopening of investigation, here reopening of investigation under section 173 subsection 8 of CRPC. When the police submitting a report before the magistrate under section 173, the magistrate may reject the report and order to reinvestigation. So this is the process here, and can be done by investigating officer only, can be done by any under order of the magistrate, can be done only after seeking opinion of public prosecutor and on the direction of a state government. Option D, can be done by the police of its own and under the order of court. So here answer is option D, can be done by police its own or order of the court. First important point here, police can done an reinvestigation by their own decision or by order of magistrate. Now question number 153. The before ordering the further investigation under section 173 subsection 8 of CRPC, the court is under the obligation to hear the accused under an obligation to hear the accused person not sent for trial. So here answer is option B, under no inhabitation. Now question number 154. The further investigation within the meaning of section 173 subsection 8 of CRPC is a continuation of the earlier investigation. Option A here. Option B, fresh investigation ab initio, wiping out the earlier investigation altogether. Reinvestigation ab initio, wiping out the earlier investigation. Option D here, A, B, C. So in this question, option A is correct here. The continuation of earlier investigation, the further investigation is conducted during the continuation of earlier investigation. Now option A is correct here. Question number 155. Section 463 of CRPC permit the oral evidence by the magistrate of confession made to him. So first of all, we are describe here which thing is provided in 463. The 463 said that the non-compliance with provision of section 164 plus here 281. So 281 provided that the signature and the oath of, and the when the statement recording, there must be the signature a confession recording by the magistrate, there must be a signature, and when the statement recorded by the magistrate, so in that time the statement is on the oath. So these are provision. So in these sections, 164 provided the confessional and the statement recorded by the magistrate of a accused or witness. So it is, these provision are provided in, and this section is one. So here 463 section here. Now question number option B here. Option B, oral evidence to prove that the procedure laid down under section 164 and CRPC had actually been followed. So 164 provided, the 164 has been actually followed it. Which section followed? 463 sections guideline followed these two sections. Which two sections? First one is this one and second one is 281. So where the record which ought to show that and does not do so? Option C, both A and B. Option D, neither A nor B. So in this question, answer is option B here. Now question number 156. Under section 172 of CRPC, it is a mandatory for every investigating officer to maintain a case diary, means CD. So said the case diary can be used during trial by court, by the police officer making a statement during trial for refreshing his memory, and by the accused to every very limited extent, all of the above. So in this answer is all of the above. It is used by the court, it is used by the police officer who make it for refreshing memory, and very limited use by the accused. So all these options are correct here, option D here. Now question number 157. Under section 167 of CRPC, an accused person can be remanded to a police custody for or a judicial custody, and the authorization of such detention cannot exceeding 14 days at one time, cannot exceeding 15 days at one time, cannot exceeding 10 days, and cannot exceeding 30 days. So now answer is here, option B, cannot exceeding 15 days. Under section 60, police remand is provided a maximum 15 days. So it is police remand, not judicial remand. It is remand. The word used here, remand, not police remand, but in the general way we call here police remand. Now question number 158. Under section 167 of CRPC, the nature of custody can be altered from judicial custody to police custody and vice versa. This alteration can be done during the period of first 7 days, during the period of first 10 days, during the period of first 15 days, during the period of first 14 days. So it is first 15 days. Now question number 159. For the authorization of detention in any custody, the accused must be produced before the magistrate. Accused need not to produce before a magistrate at all, may be produced or may not be produced, and not necessarily to be produced. So here accused must be produced before a magistrate. Option A is correct here. Now final question of this video. Section 167 of CRPC, the magistrate can authorize the detention of a total period of 90 days during investigation in case of offense punishable. I already expressed this section very verifiedly in previous video. Those who are not watching the previous videos, I will provide the link of these videos in comment box. So watch these videos please. Here now option here, option A with death, option B imprisonment for life, here death capital punishment. Now option C, imprisonment for a term not less than 10 years, and all of the, all these terms are correct here. Now option D is correct. Thank you for watching these videos, and if you like this video, please click on like button and subscribe our channel. Thank you.